This is part four of parabolas, and we go over graphing parabolas in this form, f of x equals plus or minus x minus h squared plus k, and we graph the following three parabolas. In parts 1 to 3 of parabolas, we discussed how to graph functions of the following five forms. We talked about when a parabola opened upward or downward, that depended on the coefficient of x squared. When it was positive, it went up. When it was negative, it went down. And we talked about the vertex and the axis of symmetry of the parabola. All right, so the last type we did was f of x equals x minus h squared. And we're just going to add on and say, what would it be if it was of the form a minus sign in front of it, x minus h squared? Well, the basic difference here is that it will be opening downward instead of upward. Again, because if you squared this out, you'd have a minus sign in front of the x squared. And the other thing we're going to look at is what about if we had something like x minus h squared plus k? This is a shift of both the horizontal and the vertical axis. Remember, for this one here, everything was shifted left or right, depending on h. And when we added k, everything was shifted up or down. So this is going to be both a horizontal and a vertical shift. So let's first do the one in red here. Let's do a problem like that. All right, so let's say you were going to graph f of x equals negative x plus 1 squared. Well, the axis of symmetry, remember what we do? If we have the x plus 1 in parentheses squared, we take that and set it equal to 0, and that is our axis of symmetry. So this is our axis of symmetry at x equals negative 1. Now, if that's our axis of symmetry, then our vertex is going to have that value of x for the x coordinate. So if we put in negative 1 for x, what would y be? Well, you'd have negative 0 squared. Well, the opposite of 0 is 0. So negative 1, 0 is our vertex point. Now, what about this minus sign in front? What does that tell us? That tells us it opens downward. Opens down. So what you could do is turn your graph paper over if you want, if you don't like going down. But then I just remember the usual ordered pairs for y equals x squared. And the basic ones are 0, 0, 1, 1, 2, 4, and 3, 9. That's when y equals x squared. So if I go over, so 0, 0 would be right here, right? So then I go 1, 1, but remember I'm going to go down 1. And then if I go over 2, I'm going to go down 4. Over 3, I'm going to go down 9. Now, because of this axis of symmetry, I have a point on the opposite side. And then we could connect and try to make a smooth graph as possible, and this goes forever. Now, that's one way of doing it. I find that the easiest way to do it. Another way to do it is you could certainly plug in several values for x until you get enough ordered pairs to get this picture. So another way is to simply make a chart. You could pick, negative 3, negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, whatever you want to put in, but you're going to have enough points to make sure you get the basic idea. Often what I do is when I first look at this, I make a little picture. I know that the vertex is going to be negative 1, 0. So I just say, okay, I know this is going to be at negative 1, 0, and I know it's going to go down. So I get the basic picture before I even do the real thing. And that might be helpful to you. All right, let's look at the next type. Okay, so now we're going to graph f of x equals x minus 2 squared minus 4. So if you have it in this form, the x minus 2 squared, if you want to get the axis of symmetry, You simply set that equal to 0. X minus 2 equals 0 means x equals 2. So the vertex point is going to have 2 for the x-coordinate. Now, what happens when you put 2 in here? Could you do that in your head? So you're going to have, putting in 2 for x, 0 squared. That's what it should always be, 0 squared, because you set it equal to 0, right? So it's going to be 0 minus 4, which is negative 4. So there's our vertex point. So here's a rough idea of what this is going to look like. You're going to have this vertex point, 2, negative 4, and now is it going to go up or down? Well, there's a positive sign in front of here, right? Not a negative, so this is going to go up. So you just know it's going to go up. Okay? So now we're going to get out graph paper and do it. And try this on your own first. You can do it by plotting a bunch of ordered pairs or the method I just showed you in the previous problem. Okay, so here's how I do it. I find my vertex point, or you could do the axis symmetry first, doesn't matter. Here's the axis symmetry. Always dot that line because that's where the symmetry is. And where on that is the vertex? It's at 2, negative 4. Now you can put the 2, negative 4 first and then just do the dotted line vertically. It's up to you. Now, I simply do the same sort of ordered pairs for the y equals x squared, but it's sort of like I'm pretending that's my vertex. If you want, you could dot this line too to say, oh, I'm going to pretend that's really where the x and y axis is, although it's not really the real x and y axis. So I'm going to go over 1 and up 1, over 2 and up 4, over 3 and up 9. And then there's going to be corresponding points on the other side. And there we are. This should be our graph. Now keep in mind, this is the axis symmetry, the x equals 2. This is not anything except for you to sort of think of that as a pretend x-axis. And sometimes we call that the x prime axis. So we say, realize that's all we're saying. That does not mean x to the first power. Okay, so how about trying one more? This is a little bit trickier because notice I've got this thing in parentheses, the x minus 3 squared. I have this plus 6, and I also have a minus sign out in front. That minus sign out in front is going to tell you if it opens upward or downward. That's my hint. So go ahead and try this on your own, either by putting in a bunch of ordered pairs or sort of doing that little fake wherever you're starting from your vertex and figuring it out. Okay, so here's how I do it. The axis of symmetry, I'm going to put that as AOS, axis of symmetry. Well, you set x minus 3 equal to 0, that'll be x equals 3. And that means the vertex is going to be 3. Well, what happens when you put in 3? This will always happen when you plug it in. That'll give you 0. So it really, the x coordinate is just going to always be that number. I mean, the y coordinate of the vertex is always going to be that number. Hopefully, you're seeing that. And that's if it's in this form, right? With the parentheses around the x, or if it was just x squared. So we've got 3, 6 for the vertex. So I go over 3 and up 6. There's my vertex. There's my axis of symmetry. And I know it's going to go down because of this minus sign. So in other words, I know there's a vertex and it's going to go down, and that's where the vertex is. So that's the basic idea, but if you want to get some exact points, again, instead of going over 1 and up 1, going over 1 and down 1, going over 2 and down 4, going over 3 and down 9. Corresponding points on the other side. And this is what you should have gotten if you did it using this method, or if you plugged in some ordered pairs. So here's a summarizing of our findings, graphing a parabola of this form, f of x equals, well, it could be a plus or minus in front of x minus h squared plus k. If there's a positive coefficient of x squared, in other words, in front of the parentheses in this case is positive, it opens upward. Negative, it opens downward. The axis of symmetry is x equals h. You could get that by just solving, taking the part in the parentheses and making it equal to 0 and solving for x, and the vertex is hk. Once you have that vertex, I sort of think of that as my new coordinate axes, even though it's not really there. And then I just graph the parabola either going up or down, remembering the easy numbers 0, 0, 1, 1, 2, 4, 3, 9. In other words, from y equals x squared. We're working with this particular form of a parabola, and in this form, it's easy to find the vertex and the axis of symmetry, but there will be other forms we'll be working with in later videos.